Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you differences between Sales App and Sales Console. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now we are logged into Salesforce Lightning. So if we click on this app launcher button, so here you will see various apps, those are available. And if you click on view all, so you will see all available applications. So right now I'm going to differentiate between sales and sales console. So you might have seen the sales application and this sales console. So let me first open this sales application. So if we open this sales application, so this is pre-implemented by Salesforce. And as per your requirement, you can do changes in this. So here you can see this sales app provides standard navigation with the help of tabs. So for various objects which are implemented in this org, they have related tabs, and those tabs are available at the top of this app. So first tab is home. So home basically provides various components like assistant, quarterly performance, today's event, today's task, recent items. So you can manage these things as per your requirement. So if you want to change anything in this page, so you can click on setting and you can click on edit page, and Lightning App Builder will be open and you can modify this thing. So I'm also going to demonstrate you that how you can do. Then if I click on opportunity, so it will show all available opportunities. So let me open any opportunity. So here it is opened. But after opening any opportunity record, if I move to accounts, so you will see opportunity tab is automatically closed and we are on account and we can open any account record, right? And if I open any related contact that is available on account, so you will see account is automatically closed and contact tab is opened and related record is displayed here. So this is standard navigation that is available in sales application. So now if your requirement is like we opened opportunity, through opportunity we opened account and then we opened contact. So if you want to open all related records in sub tabs so that you can easily navigate between them, so then instead of using sales standard navigation, you can use console application for navigation, right? So now I am opening this sales console application. So here you will see the records will be available in sub tabs so that you can easily navigate. So here we have a list of tabs. You can open any tab that is required. So let's say I'm opening account. So it will show all available accounts. So right now it is showing recent view. Then if I want to show all accounts, so from this list view, I can select that option and all accounts will be displayed. So now I'm opening account record. So here you can see it is open in the main tab, right? Now, if I scroll it down, so it is not having any related record. So let me open any other tab. So let's say I'm opening contact record. So you can see as I open contact, so account is available here that is open and contact is available in another tab, right? And this contact is having account associated. So now I'm going to open this account. So see, carefully see what happens. If I open this account, so you can see this contact is having now two sub tabs. This is for contact and this is for account, right? So here you can see two tabs are available, sub tabs are available, and the account which we opened that is also available in another tab, right? Now, let's say I'm opening any opportunity. So I'm opening this one. So you can see third tab is created. So our account is available here. contact is available with two subtypes. Here opportunity is available. And let's say I open this account related record for opportunity. So opportunity is now having two subtypes. And on opportunity, we have opportunity owner. So let's say I open this one also. So this opportunity is now having three subtypes. And previous records are already opened. So this way, this is console navigation where the record which you open will be available in tabs. And you can easily navigate to records of different objects. So I hope you understood how we can use console applications to manage records. Then here we have this list view option. So you can also minimize this. Whenever it is required, you can view this list view mode. So this way we can manage records in console application. Also, if you want to add any other tab, so you can add more items by clicking all. So from here you can add tabs, right? So this is the basic difference between sales application and sales console application. So I hope you understood how we can use these two different applications. Now, if you want to edit any page, so that I discussed earlier, like we can edit a particular record page. So you can click on setting and then select edit page. So Lightning App Builder will be available here in edit mode. So here all the components are available. If you want to place any other component, so from left hand side, you can simply drag and drop that component. So first it shows standard components and then custom components. So you can drag and drop and then you can save and activate that particular edited page. So if you want to know more about these Lightning record pages, how we can manage them, so you can watch my another video in this playlist. So then you will get to know how you can edit this Lightning record page and you can use it in your org or any particular application. So right now I'm leaving this page. So I hope you understood the difference between sales and sales console in this video. That was our main topic. So if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my channel so that you can find various videos related to Salesforce. Thank you for watching this video.